The first time I heard about this was in a Toastmasters meeting at Madrid Advanced Speakers. I found it amazing. And that's what I'm going to share with you right now. So, which are our five senses? Sight,
touch,
smell, hearing, and taste. Thank you. So, with these five senses, we perceive the whole world around us. And each of these senses is related with a concrete organ of our body. So vision or sight is related with our eyes, and through them we perceive the visible universe. Then audition, through our ears we perceive the audible universe. Then touch, with which organ is related touch? It says it's not so easy. The skin as a whole, of course. And it's not only that we can perceive contact with another one or with something, but we can also distinguish between something hot and cold, or hard and soft, smooth and rough, and so on. Then smell is associated with our nose, and taste with our nose. And both smell and taste work very closely in sensing and enjoying food. So thanks to these five senses that all of us have, we perceive and we can enjoy life and everything around us. But each of us here does it in a different way, because each of us has a different preferred sense. The preferred or dominant sense is the sense with which you feel most comfortable when you use it. So, which is your preferred sense? Have you ever thought about it? In order to identify it, I'm going to ask you some questions. Question number one. Which is your preferred art form? Paintings? Music? Or perhaps sculpture? Think about it. Then a situation. When you meet someone, or you remember someone you have met, do you focus on how they look? On what they say? Or mostly on the feelings that they express? Another example. You want to talk over something that is very important for you with your boss, so his mood is actually important. And you are trying to interpret it in order to identify a proper situation. Do you focus mostly on his facial expression? Or perhaps you listen precisely to his tone of voice? Or do you watch his body movements? Interesting, huh? The last question. When you are concentrating, do you get most distracted by untidiness, by noises, or by movement? Even more, your preferred sense becomes also evident in the way you speak and move. For example, if you are a visual person, you will probably use expressions like "I see," "Have a look," "Let's see." On the other hand, if you are an auditive person, you will use expressions like "I have heard," or "Tell me." And also, your gestures will show that hearing is a very important sense of perception for you. By doing gestures like this, for instance, that you put your hands near your ears because you are listening very carefully to the words you hear. And if you are a more physical person, you will express it through verbs like "I feel," "grasp," "that has impressed me." And also, when you meet people, you will show it with your body, because you will tend to touch them when you meet them, because it's important for you and you feel comfortable with it. So, if you have not yet identified your preferred scents or the most that are most important for you, at the end of the meeting I can give you a questionnaire. This is from Brian Tracy, an author, a book author about these topics, where you can see much also other situations and reflect and go deeper. So once you have identified your preferred scents, you can take advantage of it and make learning more effective and easier for you. If you are a visual person, you will retain much more information when you see something graphical. So use visual aids, such as diagrams, pictures, illustrations. If you are an auditory person, your learning style will be also more auditory. That means you will retain more information when you hear something. Then attend lectures, seminars, watch webinars on the internet, read something loud that you want to learn. It also works, you can hear something and repeat it loud. And if your personal learning style is more physical, then it will work for you better a hands-on approach. Go to labs, make demonstrations, try everything yourself. So this knowledge has helped me get to know myself better. I have understood why the written and spoken word is so important to me, why I enjoy so much classical music, and why I tend to read everything I get my hands on. Also small food, small footprint and footnotes and small print. And the most important discovery for me, why Taboo is my favorite board game.